about the NVA toric precision lens. And they just said to me, okay, talk about it. Explain us your personal experience. And I am really happy that they live free. So there's no selling, it's just the truth. And this is something great today in day. So I called the presentations director's cut for a simple reason. Because I think the best way to understand lens is to go back to the creation of the lens and think, why was this lens created by time? So where was the reason, the idea of the engineer who designed it? So far away from any commercial aspect, there was an idea when they launched in 2018 the new precision presbyopic toric lens. And the idea of the creator was to make a premium lens, a premium multifocal lens. So premium for me, it's never a lens. Actually, premium for me, it's the way the patient looks at you the day after surgery, and 1 week after surgery, and 1 year after surgery. If the patient is happy and he's smiling, this is premium. A lens won't be premium. You can't measure premium in the focus curves or in side effects. You have to measure it in the satisfaction of your patient. And the lens was designed to have less complaints and higher satisfaction. So here is the goals for any multifocal lens. We want a wide range of focus. We want to see far away. We want to see close and intermediate. We want to have low side effects, good contrast, and high tolerance to astigmatism. So the other thing is that it would be nice that we are less dependent on the alpha, that we are less dependent on the pupilla size. When I see this, I always think about this. This is an intelligence test. I think a lot of people know this. You have those 9 dots, and you have to put 4 lines to put them together. No, so yes, you can do it. They say 20 seconds. You're intelligent. You do it in 5. And so this is the This is the answer. So easy. No, this was easy. And now, do it with 3 lines, and you have only 5 seconds. So that's the situation. You put an engineer when you tell him, please build the perfect multifocal lens, because it's almost impossible. You can't put all those points together with only 3 lines. So let's try it. We will see this. So here we have once again our image, and now try to move the lens to make it premium. So if you move it here and you put far away contrast and low glare together, you have a monofocal approach. This is a far lens. So this is a normal monofocal lens, and the patient will be unhappy with close sight. You can do the opposite, and you move it there. Now we have a myopic approach. Patient will be happy with close sight. He will immediately get little halos, because myopia will create little halos, and for sure, he has no faraway sight. So let's do a trifocal. We have a good faraway sight, we have a good intermediate sight, and we have a good close sight. But you will have halos, you will have some compromised contrast, and you will have low tolerance to astigmatism. Oh yes, and here to stop the EDOF lens, EDOF lenses, low glares, good faraway sight, but problems with contrast and with close sight. They need spectacles for reading. So the precision NVA lens was based on another idea. They tried to make a balance between range, quantity, and quality of sight. So it was just a new intelligent idea, and that's the reason why they launched a new lens. Otherwise, they should have gone with the old lenses. So this balance is not only the performance of the lens, but as well the technology of the lens. We will see it later why it's balanced. So here are the goals we achieve with the lens, and we will go through the lens. We have only 10-15 minutes, so we have to be fast, but I think we can get the key messages. So let's talk about vision, natural vision, and the contrast. And precision work with a multi-segment design, which will create multiple focus, and then they will be put together by elongation of the focus. So tomorrow there will be an interesting lecture about continuous transitional focus, and I think it's best we leave it to them tomorrow to explain the details. Just to show you, here we have this 11 aspheric refractive segments. Every segment is with variation of power. So we have the multiple focus, and now the variation of power in each segment will unify. And that's the way how we get a smooth from close to far with low side effects. Come tomorrow and see the presentation tomorrow. So this is CTF. Here we have a really nice binocular defocus curve. And this was the nicest one I found, but there are others. So in the clinical trials, if you look at all of them, close performance, you will have some clinical trials who will be a bit worse than the nice one from the beginning. But the message is that in this area, from minus 0.5 to minus 0.3 defocus, we always stay above the line for EDOF. We are far above the limits for EDOF. Always in 0.2 logMAR. And we are almost approaching a defocus curve from a trifocal lens. So the corrector of the refractive focus we get with the NVA lens makes a clear and natural image. And good contrast and good quality of sight is published in several trials. Okay, let's speak about the high tolerance of pupil position size. For this, the designer made a large central zone, which is like butterfly shaped, and it goes from 0.4 to 2.6 millimeters, and this will allow you to put the visual axis always in this central area. So high alpha angles won't be a problem because you can just shift the lens in the visual axis. And by this multi-segment design with a balanced distribution between far and near segments, the pupil size is not so important. You will always have side of your pupil independent of a pupil of 1.5 millimeter up to 5 millimeter. So here we see how you move the lens when you implant in the visual axis. For sure, it's on the front. You see it from the side. And so main subject in precision to A lens is the correction of astigmatism. We know all about the importance to correct astigmatism to get clear image, get a good quality of image. And little deviations of the axis is related to a high loss in quality of image. But the deviation of the axis is not only related to the rotation after surgery. Often, it's not the problem. Those lenses are really stable, and there are some clinical trials who show it, and I'm happy to announce that we will make soon another one who will show the same thing, that we have really stable rotation. The big problem in misalignment is that the calculators will give you different axes, that you have oblique astigmatisms, you have irregular astigmatisms, your topography will give you each time another K. So the error is there. And a more forgiving lens would be a great to create more confidence to put more toric lenses. So the NVA toric lens will show little variations in alignment will not compromise the visual outcome. And you might know a slide from Optic that a 5% a 5 degree misalignment will only cause 8% of lost quality and not as high as normal toric lenses. So this is due to the patented transitional conic toric technology. And in this moment, I'm really happy that I only have 10 minutes and I don't need to explain it. Maybe you can later speak about it. Basically, you have several cones. It's not one cylinder. There's a smooth shaping from the center to the periphery, and you have the same spherical equivalence in the whole lens. So that's why it's more tolerant. Okay, important thing, low glare and halo. I think Optic is proud of this low side effects. And it's true that those lenses have less side effects, less tropic and phenomena than, for example, a diffractive trifocal lens. I tell less, I can't tell none. And I think it's really important that you understand that the patient will never make the experience how it is with a trifocal lens, because he won't wear a trifocal lens in one eye and an NVA in the other. So if you tell them you will have less, he won't understand. You need to tell them you will have some starburst, you will have some halos, and then he will be happy. Never never promise something you can't help. So it's really important that you show him Optec is right. They can get used to them, but speak about it. So this really confusing slide is for choosing the right patient. One key message in this, look on the expectations of your patients, try to accomplish with the expectation of your patients and find the right lens for every patient. Unhappy patients are dangerous and crazy creatures. You don't want them in your clinic. So so two key messages, under promise, over deliver. Never lose ability, which a patient has. Never give a myo patient not a good close sight, and always keep your promise. So what can you promise in MVA lenses? You can promise a really 20/20 distant sight. In most of the trials, we saw 0.01 logma, and this is great. And you can promise a good uncorrected intermedium and near visual acuity. Actually, we are the biggest part of the patients. They are better than 0.2 logma. So here are the publications. So 0.2 logma, where is it? This is here. So low. This is really small. 0.2 logma sounds like not so much, but it is really good. With 0.2 logma, your patient can read a phone, your patient can read a book, your patient can see what he's eating, your patient can use a computer. So when you have the big questions, but do I need to wear spectacles? I try to say to patients, maybe. It's a good tool. If you wear spectacles, this is great, because then you can read in lower light conditions and you have more contrast. You can work for hours on the computer and it won't be a problem. So keep it like a tool you can use, but you don't need to use it. So do it however you want, but I would recommend, why not? So the messages and summary, for me, the NVA toric is a lens for as a first choice if you have a hyperopic patient, if you have a presbyopic patient, for sure if you have a cataract, so do it. Don't think about it. Don't look after other lenses. You can do this lens as a first choice. We have this rescue indication, which is if the alpha angle is high, you want to implant a trifocal lens, and then you decide to implant a precision lens. But if you have a hyperopic, presbyopic patient, you don't need this. If he has a good angle, if he's a good patient, do it, put a presbyopic lens inside a precision lens, he will be happy. Same thing with EDOF. If you have an EDOF approach and the patient needs to look closer, so a precision lens helps you to accomplish this expectation. So last message, the NVA precision toric lens, for me, it's a really good choice as a first choice.